My name is Suzette Hutton and it's my joy and pleasure to welcome you at this video. We are going to talk about 4 points of the pillars of prayer. Let's start with number one, worship. God has called us to worship. God is looking for the worshipper more than what he's actually looking for the worship. That means God is looking for you. God is looking for you exactly the way you are. He's looking for you to come into his presence and simply worship him the way you are comfortable. It doesn't have to be a special location. It doesn't have to be a special place. It is you communicating with God. Worship your way. Worship if it's singing, although it doesn't have to be singing, if it's just glorifying his name, or however you are comfortable in worshiping God. Many people like to worship with music. That's perfectly fine. But most important is that you make time just to worship him. Not for what you want, not for what we believe for, but just because he's God. Secondly, what I believe is one of the pillars of prayer is actually praying God's word, moving with the prompting. If you worship, the Holy Spirit will actually prompt you. He will prompt you to pray now about this. He will put something in your heart to pray about. He will maybe put somebody in your mind. He would put somebody in your spirit. He would put a person or a place or sometimes just something he wants you to pray. Or sometimes he might even give you a scripture that he wants you to pray. So move with the prompting of the Holy Spirit. That which is that moment stirring your heart, that is what the Holy Spirit wants you to pray. Thirdly, I think one of the most very important subjects that most people don't like to hear is fasting. Fasting is not changing God, fasting is changing us. We cannot force the hand of God with fasting, but fasting makes us more sensitive. We are focused on God. We actually put the natural aside and say we look for the spiritual. When last have you set a day aside just to pray about that which God wants you to do for him? Or just even just to come closer to him? Or just to humble your spirit before him? Fasting is a vital part of our pillars in prayer. And then lastly, involve the body of Christ. I think it's very important that we teach the body of Christ how to pray unitedly, how to pray one direction, one vision, one word sometimes. That is not actually to copy. I'm not saying unity means conformity. No, it actually means variety. But at the same time, it means worship. It means like a symphony. That's really the word unity. Yes, we are like a symphony. We are different instruments, different sounds, different ways, as long as we sing the song of the redeemed together. I think to involve the body of Christ is vital. We see all over the Word of God that they actually pray unitedly. We see it again and again in the New Testament that they came together. They prayed together before the outpour of the Holy Spirit. Afterwards, when they were persecuted, they came together and they lifted their voice together. I think united prayer is vital. And unfortunately, that's something that is very much neglected in many, many of our churches or in the body of Christ. They say, oh, we pray at church, or we pray at home, or I pray by myself. Nothing has as much power as the power of agreement. You agreeing with the Word of God, you agreeing in your family, you agreeing with other believers, you coming before God, one vision, one mind, one heart, one scripture, and see how the four pillars of prayer change your life. I am happy and look forward to teaching even more on these subjects.